Hey everybody, this is Phil at Behringer. Welcome to Music Group TV. Thanks for watching. I want to talk some more about the X-Air, other cool features on the X-Air that you can use on the X-Air Edit app as well as the X-Air products from Behringer. What we're going to talk about today is effects, sends, and effects. Usually aux sends and effects sends and stuff tend to confuse people, and it's really a simple concept. If I were to live in a neighborhood and there were four houses in a row and they all four houses had kids, let's just say, and all of those kids need to go to the same school, what are they going to do? They're all going to get on the same bus and get sent to one location, to the school. That's what an effect send is. I can take a lot of different tracks and I can send them to the same location, to the same reverb, to the same delay, whatever I want to. So if I had five or six backup vocalists, maybe I don't need the same amount of reverb on each one of them. So I can send different amounts of each backup vocalist to a reverb so that they have a nice blend. And then the output of the reverb, I can also select whether I want it to come back to my left-right stereo mix or if I want it to come somewhere else. So what's handy about that, let's take a look at the track. I have my track here, my input on channel one, and we're just going to go to the sends page. Now, as you can see right here, I have some sends going on. And I can choose how much level to go to each effect. And on my effects page are my actual effects. I have a reverb is send one. I have a plate reverb, which is a bigger reverb on two. I have a stereo delay on three set to a kind of a longer time and a stereo delay on effects four. And it's so simple to get to them. For instance, I'm gonna unmute the effect return here. These are my effect returns over here. And I can have them muted or not, or have the gain level up or not. So here I'm bringing up effects one for the exercise, and I'm gonna send a level of my voice over to it. Now what you're hearing is this room reverb, which is a nice little slapback reverb, what we call slapback reverb. It's a short time. If I wanna edit it, I can click edit here and I can change the dimensions of the room, things like that. So it's kinda handy to have. Now let's bring that one down and go to the next effect. It's as simple as bringing down the effect send on the send page, bringing up the next one. So if I bring this up and unmute the reverb, which is send two, you can see I have a nice big reverb. You see the input level and the output level of the reverb. And I have a lot of effects here. I mean, this is my list of effects that I get to choose from. I have all kinds of delays and graphic EQs and compressors and choruses, you know, things for every instrument that you're gonna plug into your rig, I guarantee it. Guitar amps, pitch shifters, there's just a lot of fun going on here. So this is my big reverb sound. Now, if I bring down that send and I go to the next one, I can go ahead and have a signal. And that's a long delay.
That's a long delay.
Right, and you can hear it. Right. If I kill that one and bring up send four, that's a little bit of a shorter delay. And the cool thing about a short delay is that it does sound cool, and I have a couple of reverbs and short reverb, and this is a short delay. And the only difference between a reverb and a delay is that a reverb is so many delays close together, so close together, that you can't tell the difference between one and another. So if you're in a gymnasium, you clap your hands and you hear that big sound, it's a lot of delays so close together that they have become reverb. That's all that is. So the other cool thing about this though, is if I have this delay and I can hear it really clearly, and sometimes for backup vocals and things like that, that can be a little obtrusive. So if I bring back the high gain here, all of a sudden I have a backup vocal or a delay that's not really fighting the lead vocal, the main signal. This is handy to use on a delay. Don't just assign a delay and get away with it. If you can adjust it and make it better, go for it. If it's great out of the box, go for that. So I just wanted to give you that little tip about delays, because especially with backup vocals, it comes into play a lot. And it'll make your lead vocal, again, pop through, and your backup vocals will sound full, and they'll sound like they're supporting the lead vocal, and yet they're not getting in the way of the lead vocal. They are truly backup vocals. So you have the sends page here, which is where you're gonna send, and I can give the example with all these things on if I want to, because I have four sends per channel on the X-Air. So now I can have these all going at the same time for quite a cacophony, or I can turn them off so that we can just talk. And basically, that's on the X-Air, how simple it is to send signals to an effect and have the return come back and be able to choose effects. We'll have more videos later. Thanks for watching.